During this week's episode, Alex teaches us all about pronation, which is either what you should be doing on your overhead smash or this. Let's break it down.
Here's how this works. You send us highlights, great plays, good plays, and not so good plays. With the help of Coach Alex Fox, we break it down. You learn, we watch, and we all get better. This is Pickleball Breakdown.
All right, Alex, here we go down to California where we got Scott and Mitch in the far court against Ted and Joe here in the near court. And early on in this point, there doesn't seem to be anybody with the advantage.
It's all pretty much neutral ground right now. Then Joe sends this ball way out wide to Scott's backhand, being a lefty. There might have been an opportunity here for an around the post from Scott, but Ted had it well covered there. So maybe that caused him to change his mind, or maybe it was because it was to his backhand and it had just been a tough shot.
So Scott does a really good job of chasing this ball down and sends it Joe's way. And Joe has an opportunity here. He's one-on-one with Mitch over there, and Mitch is right there square in the middle of the court. And what I see here, and I'd love your take on this, is Joe puts it right on Mitch's forehand, and I'm not really sure why.
I would have liked to seen Joe go behind Mitch here over to his sideline, creating more of a gap between Scott and Mitch. Instead, he kind of allows Scott to get back into the court and into the point here.
Good for Mitch because he gets this ball here. There's an opportunity there. Ted tries to take it, but Mitch is just running all over this court.
He's a madman. He's all over the place. I love it. I love the scrap. What I really liked about that was, I mean, it's a great get a paddle on the ball, get it back over the net. Joe kind of lets him off the hook here. Now, when somebody's going full speed off to the side of the court, tracking a ball, you want to isolate that player. What I mean by that is not just hitting it back to the person who's established. If they're on the ropes, you got to keep them there.
And so really at this point, just freeze this shot right here. And you look at where Scott and Mitch are way back there, not even anywhere on the blue on the court. And you've got Ted and Joe in really good position. If you had to lay some money down right now, who's going to win this point?
I would definitely say Ted and Joe. They've pretty much controlled this point so far, and Scott and Mitch have definitely been on the defense.
But spoiler alert, it doesn't turn out that way. Let's find out what goes wrong for poor Ted and Joe. What happens here?
Oh, we have a classic case of the kitchen invite here from Ted. What I would have liked to see, Frank, is that he just pins him back, rolls some heavy topspin towards the baseline, and forces them to make a mistake from back there. But instead, he lets them come up and get established at the kitchen line.
Yeah, that one soft shot by Ted. And now look at this. All four players are just quickly at the line.
Just like that, it's back to neutral.
Yeah, it is right back to neutral. And this is where Mitch takes control and puts up a pretty good lob.
Right, and what happens is they both end up on the same side of the court here, talking about Ted and Joe. They do a switch here, but Mitch really hits a well-placed and well-executed overhead with some really good pronation, getting some good power going to the right side of the court.
What do you mean by that, by pronation?
So at the top of his swing here on his overhead, his wrist really comes down and outward to his right, getting that that quick snap. That's where a lot of the power comes from on overhead. It's not from muscling it and trying to swing really hard. It's really just having a nice smooth motion, and then at the very top of that swing, snapping that wrist down and outward.
A lot of back and forth in this point, some really good play from everybody, and really wild swings as it went from Ted and Joe having the momentum to Scott and Mitch having the momentum, and finally just a good put away by Mitch wins it.
Right, and it just goes to show how quickly points can develop and change. So when you have the offense, really try to keep it and don't let your opponents back into the point if you can do anything about it.
That's going to do it for this episode of Pickleball Breakdown. If you want us to break down your game, send a link to your video to pickleballbreakdown@gmail.com. Submissions need to be a minute or less and in MP4 format. If you like this episode, share it, rate it, like it, and subscribe. See you next time.